So here I have a fairly basic video player, and I like to create a button that when pressed, changes the video being played. Here's how I go about doing it. So first, we need to create a button. I'm going to come into my hierarchy and go right click 3D object cube. I'm going to rename it to change video button. I'm going to fly around to roughly where I want it to be and go Control Shift F to place it where I am. And then I'm going to modify its rotation as well as scale it down to 0.15. Now, as is a button and I don't want players to collide with it, I'm going to come to its box collider and hit is trigger and make it true. And now I want to give it some logic, so I'm going to come down to add component and create an Udon behavior component. Now we just need a script to go inside this Udon behavior component. I'm going to come over to the project window and go right click, create VRChat Udon Udon Graph Program Asset, and I'm going to call it change URL. And then I'm going to open up the Udon graph. Now that we're in the Udon graph, I'm going to come over to the variables tab and hit this little plus button and create a base VRC video player. I'm going to change its name to be video player, and we want to hit this little drop down menu and make it public so we can select it inside the inspector. We also want to create another variable, and this time we're going to create a VRC URL. I'm going to call it target URL, and I'm going to hit the little drop down menu and make this one public as well. Now, coming into the graph, we want to right click create node, the shortcut for this is spacebar, and go video player play URL. This node will change the URL as well as make the video player play it. Now, depending on what you're doing, you may find the node video player load URL to be more fitting. Now, this node requires two things. It needs to know the video player, and it needs to know the URL that we want to play. I'm going to drag and drop our video player variable, and I'm going to plug it into the instance slot. I'm then also going to drag and drop the URL into the URL slot. So now, whenever this node is called, it will tell the video player to play this URL. Now, we just need to say when we want this node to be called. So I'm going to go create node, event interact, and plug it into the arrow slot. So now, whenever we click the button, it will play this node. Awesome! So now, hit compile and come into the scene view. We want to click on our button and drag and drop our new script into the Udon behavior component. I'm then just going to change its interact text to be play video 1. Now we need to tell it our video player. To do so, you'll need to come over to your video player and it will either have the component VRC AV Pro video player or the component VRC Unity video player. Either one is fine as they both essentially do the same thing. Once you find it, come over to your button and drag and drop the object with it into the video player slot. Now all that's left is the URL, and as copyright is a thing, I'm just going to give it the link to one of my videos. Awesome, so now it's time to test this. And now that we're in the world, we can see that the video player is playing a video. And when I click the button, after a short wait while it finds the video, we'll see that my new video is being played. Awesome! So now, currently this only changes the video locally, but what if we wanted to change it for everyone? So, coming back into the script, we need to make a small change. So, I'm going to come into the graph and go create node custom event. I'm then going to call it change URL, and I'm going to plug it into the play URL node. Now, I'm going to grab the event interact node, and instead of it going into the change URL node, I'm instead going to put it into a Udon behavior send custom networked event. I'm then going to make sure its target is set to all, and I'm going to change this event to be the custom event that we just made. So now, whenever we click this button, it will tell everyone in the scene to play this event, causing everyone to change the video being played. Awesome! So now, hit compile, and we want to play and test with two instances so we can test out the networking. And now that we're in the world, we can see that when one player hits the button, it changes the video for both players. Neat! So now, back in Unity, if we want to create some more buttons, we can simply click on our button and go Ctrl D to duplicate it. Change its interact text to be something different and give it a new URL. And with that, you now have another button. Awesome! Also, on a bit of a tangent, if we come back into the graph and let's say you want to get a bit advanced and create a custom URL unique to each player by say adding the username to the end of the URL. Unfortunately, VRChat does not currently support the creation of URLs while the game is running. At least not by code. All URLs either have to be typed in by the player or baked in when creating the world. The SDK will literally stop you, but if you do find a workaround, unfortunately that goes strictly against VRChat's terms of services. Perhaps that's a little overprotective, but hey, that's what it is. Anyways, hopefully you found this helpful. Feel free to leave a like on the video if you liked it, leave a comment down below if you have any questions, and feel free to check out some of my other tutorials that I have on the channel. But until next time, bye!